Final report of the commercial starship Nostromo. Third officer reporting. The other members of the crew. Kane, Lambert, Parker, Brett, Ash, and Captain Dallas are dead. Cargo and ship destroyed. I should reach the frontier in about 6 weeks. With a little luck, the network will pick me up. This is Ripley. Last survivor of the Nostromo. Signing off.
Samuels. I work for the company. A commercial vessel, the Anisadora, has recovered what we believe to be the flight recording unit of the Nostromo.
Where?
Zeta Reticula. Taken to Sevastopol station. It's proprietorial material, so the company wants it to be collected as soon as possible. Sevastopol's a supply depot in the region. It's a permanent freeport.
I know what it is.
Transit's arranged. There's a courier ship called the Torrance heading out that way in 2 days. We're going to travel out. Me and another exec. And you, if you're willing. Look, Ripley, when this job came across my desk, I read the case history. I know why you're working in the region where she went missing. You're still looking. I've been cleared to offer you a place on the Torrance if you want to come along. Maybe there'll be some closure for you.
Ripley.
Samuels, did you wake up early?
Just inspecting the Torrens facilities. A well-maintained ship.
The Nostromo?
Yes, M-class. A later pattern, but close in spec.
I've worked engineering jobs on ships like this.
Of course. She's not a seasoned traveler. Hypersleep may have been punishing for her.
Haven't seen her. I'll go check on her. Taylor, good morning.
Sorry. I feel like death. I don't know how you people put up with hypersleep regularly.
You get used to it.
I don't do long haul, though. Mostly...
I'm surprised Weyland-Yutani felt the need to send legal at all.
The loss of the Nostromo and its cargo cost the company a lot of money. It's important we find out what happened. If I can close the case with a conclusive accident report, it'll look great with my superiors. I'm sorry. That was insensitive. I realize your mother has been missing for 15 years and you...
It's okay. We'll both get what we want, right? Looks like we're up.
She was a wreck when I bought her. Took a watch the approach on the monitors.
Can we see it?
Switch to monitors. Sevastopol Station.
Is that damage?
Looks like damage.
Punch up 74, tight angle.
Looks like the dry dock bay is screwed.
I can't bring the Torrens into that.
This is a commercial vessel, Torrens, out of St. Clair, registration number MSV7760, calling Sevastopol Traffic Control. We're carrying three passengers on a Weyland.
Yutani Bond, you're holding the Nostromo flight record. Unit. We request immediate permission to transfer the passengers port side over.
This waits. Colonial Marshal, Sevastopol State. Serious situation.
Hello, Marshal? Marshal, this is the Torrens. Say again.
I'm
comms seem pretty screwed up, so I fitted Samuel's suit with a radio booster. I can only keep the Torrens in transit for 24 hours.
You'll have heard from us by then.
Safe trip.
Stand by. It's the only option, and it's perfectly safe if you do what I tell you. This'll help. Doesn't anything here work?
Harris, Turner, get back here now. We have a track somewhere in engineering. Lock the terminal down, kill the power, and don't forget your reports. Make them thorough. We're gonna need our paperwork to be bulletproof when this shit's over. Wait till...
Here.
Jones today's update. After numerous demands, Marshal Waits finally called a public meeting to address the rumors that have been circulating on Sevastopol. But instead of the answers we wanted, he continued to be evasive, and after only a few minutes, he and his team were pelted by projectiles from an angry crowd. A gun was fired, there was panic, and now Waits and what's left of his team are forcibly ejecting us from the terminal. Feels like we're on our own now.
This place is falling apart.
That's gotta be the exit up ahead.
It's Turner. Got to deal with that wasted asshole again. This time he nearly wrecked the door with a maintenance jack. Guess he figures it's safe here. Wants to lock himself in. Screw him. We got too much to worry about without babysitting drunks. Anyway, I threw him in the evidence lockup. Let the son of a bitch sleep it off.